Hello and welcome to Isaweb TV. We are here in Madrid in front of Keops. Keops is the satellite that will be looking at exoplanets, and next to me is Kate Isaac. She's the project scientist of this mission. So explain to us what it is for.
With pleasure. KEOPS is a satellite in ESA's science program. The acronym KEOPS stands for Characterizing Exoplanets Satellite, and that is exactly what we will do. We will observe stars that are known to host exoplanets. So in that way, we know where to point and when to point. And we will measure the output of these stars and look for the transit of the planet across the disk of the star. So we will look for the small changes in light that will take place when a planet moves across the star. Our observations could take 6, 8, 10, 12 hours. And by measuring the dip, we can determine the size of the planet. By combining the size of the planet with its mass, we're able to determine its mean density. By combining this with information that we have about the host star itself, we can start to say something very concrete about the composition of the planet, its internal structure, and so start to lead on to its structure, formation, and evolution history. Very important information about planets beyond our own solar system.
And this is the first time this is done. I mean, you know where to look at, but you don't know exactly. I mean, this is the added value of KEOPS.
The added value of KEOPS is we're following up on known targets. So instead of missions such as Kepler, TESS, and indeed Plato, ESA's future exoplanet mission, we know where to point. So we're able to make very efficient observations. We move and point towards a star when we know that the planet is going to transit. So instead of spending several months, maybe, pointing at a blank fraction of the sky, looking for the transits, monitoring very many thousands of stars, and looking for small dips in their output, we're able to go quickly around the sky, maybe spend 10, 20, 30 hours on known stars, known bright stars, and to measure the sizes of their planets in that way.
You mentioned the dip, meaning that it will be something in front of the star or the sun, because it's solar systems you are looking at in a way.
Planetary systems. So what we're doing is we're looking at the planets as they orbit around their host star. So in the same way that the Earth goes around our star, our sun, other planets orbit their own host stars. And what we will do is we will monitor these stars and we will look for these dips. As the planet moves across the disk of the star, as seen by us from a large distance, we're able to determine the size of the planet from the small dip in the output of the star. So in the light that we measure from the star.
You will be able to tell us if there are Earth-like planets and life on these?
We'll be focusing on small planets, so Earth to Neptune size planets. And by combining the sizes, the very precise and accurate sizes that we will get with measurements from KEOPS, with measurements of mass that will be made from telescopes and observatories on Earth, we can get the density. Now, as you know, density is something that tells us about what the planet is made of. Something that has a high density, something like iron, is very much more compact. Whereas if something has a low density, it's more gassy. Earth is somewhere in between. And so by being able to work something out about the density, we're able to say something about whether the planet is Earth-like or whether it's more gassy instead.
Quite fascinating. Well, we will be following this mission, which will be launched by a Soyuz from Kourou. So we will meet again very soon in French Guiana. Thank you.
Looking forward to it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.